Today, we are going to study about the racemose type of inflorescence. Last class, we have seen the introduction about inflorescence and the differences between racemose type and cymose type we have seen. Today, we will see the racemose type of inflorescence in detail. In the racemose type of inflorescence, the inflorescence axis contain apical bud at the top, which grows continuously and produce numerous flowers on either side of the inflorescence axis. Here in the racemose type of inflorescence, the arrangement of flower is acropetal because the old flowers are arranged at the base of the inflorescence axis and the young flowers and buds are arranged at the apex of the inflorescence axis. Here the opening of the flower is centripetal because the old flowers which are situated at the bottom of the inflorescence axis will open first, and the tip of the inflorescence axis having very young flowers and bud will flower later, will open later. So such a type of opening of the flower is called centripetal. Racemose type is classified into three types based on the growth pattern of the inflorescence axis. Based on the growth pattern of the inflorescence axis, there are three types of racemose type classified. Number one, main axis elongated. Number two, main axis shortened. And number three, main axis flattened or globose. First, we'll see the main axis elongated. The main axis here, the inflorescence axis is very much elongated. Pedicellated or sessile flowers are produced on the inflorescence axis. Pedicellated flowers are flowers with pedicel. Sessile flowers are flowers without pedicel. So that is the things. The main axis elongated is further classified into number one, simple raceme, number two, spike inflorescence, number three, spikelet inflorescence, number four, catkin inflorescence, number five, spadix inflorescence, number six, panicle inflorescence. These are all the six types of racemose inflorescence and main axis elongated. The first one is simple raceme. In the simple raceme, the inflorescence axis is unbranched and that produces pedicellated flowers on either side of the inflorescence axis in the acropetal fashion. For example, Crotalaria retusa, mustard and radish. In these plants, simple raceme can be produced. So this is the main axis. The main axis produces pedicellated flowers in acropetal fashion. Opening of the flower is centripetal. So here the inflorescence axis will grow indefinitely and produce numerous flowers on either side of the inflorescence axis. Second, a spike inflorescence. Here also the main axis of the inflorescence is unbranched and that produces sessile flowers. Between simple raceme and spike inflorescence, only one difference. In the simple raceme, pedicellated flowers are produced on the inflorescence axis in the acropetal fashion, but in simple spike inflorescence, on the unbranched inflorescence axis, sessile flowers are produced in the acropetal fashion. Opening of the flower is centripetal. For example, in the case of Aegiranthus stachytophyta, in these plants, spike type of inflorescence can be produced. The third type is spikelet type of inflorescence. Spikelet is a small spike-like inflorescence with branched central axis. Each branch is a spikelet. Here you can see this is the spikelet inflorescence. There are several branches are produced. Each one is called spikelet. Sessile flowers are produced in acropetal succession here. A pair of inflorescence bright produce that is called glumes. What are glumes? Glumes are a pair of bracts, inflorescence bract. At the base of the inflorescence, there are two bract can be seen. Those bracts produced in the spikelet inflorescence called glumes. Bract of each sessile flower in the inflorescence, each flower is also having a bract. Flowers, the bract of each sessile flower is called lemma in spikelet inflorescence. Bracteoles of each sessile flower, that is called pallea. In the flowers of spikelet inflorescence, tepals are reduced to scaly leaves. Those scaly leaves are called lodicules. Each flower has a stamen and pistil only. In paddy, in the case of wheat, in barley, in sorghum, spikelet inflorescence are produced. The next type is catkin inflorescence. It is a pendulous spike type of inflorescence. It's having long and drooping inflorescence axis with unisexual or bisexual flowers. It's also called amand. Other name for catkin is called amand. For example, in the case of Acalypha hispida, Prosopis juliflora, and Piper nigrum, catkin type of inflorescence is produced. The next type is spadix type of inflorescence. In the spadix type of inflorescence, the main specialty is the presence of fleshy inflorescence axis. The inflorescence axis is thick and fleshy and produces many unisexual flowers in the acropetal succession. Two types of flowers are produced. Sessile flowers are produced, female flowers and male flowers. Female flowers are found at the base of the inflorescence axis and male flowers are produced at the apex of the inflorescence axis. The whole inflorescence is covered by a brightly colored and hard bract. This is the brightly colored hard bract that covers the whole inflorescence, that is called spath. What is a spath? Spath is a brightly colored hard bract of the whole inflorescence that covers the whole inflorescence, that is called spath. In the case of Amorphophallus, Colocasia, Phoenix, Coccus nucifera, spadix type of inflorescence can be produced. The speciality in the spadix type of inflorescence is the inflorescence axis is fleshy, thick, and that produces many unisexual flowers, male flowers and female flowers. Both male flowers and female flowers are produced from the inflorescence axis, which are arranged in the acropetal fashion. The opening of the flower is centripetal. The next type is, the last type in racemose type of inflorescence is panicle. Panicle is always called branched raceme. Branched raceme is called panicle. Several racemes, several simple racemes are produced, one at the same inflorescence axis, that is the panicle inflorescence. It's otherwise called compound raceme because it's a combination of several simple raceme, and it's otherwise called raceme of raceme. This is the panicle inflorescence. This is one simple raceme. This is another simple raceme. So this is another simple raceme. So several simple racemes are grouped together and form a compound raceme that is called panicle. So otherwise called raceme of raceme. In the case of racemes, the panicle inflorescence can be seen. So today we have seen several types of racemose inflorescence. What is racemose type of inflorescence? What are the special characteristic feature of racemose type? How the racemose inflorescence are classified? And each type we have seen with diagram. That's all.